Chapter 6 is long. There's a lot of problems. Alright. Okay. Alright. So, first of all, here's what we're going to do today. I kind of have a mini outline of what we're doing up here. We're going to do a quick review where I went through the slides that we did yesterday of the four theorems, 6-9, 6-10, 6-11, 6-12. I'll basically show you kind of what we've been doing, what we're going to need to do. We are getting homework today. It'll be due next Tuesday. Don't complain, you guys love the drill. I can give you way more homework.
No, that's
all right. So now for today, we're gonna review these properties, and then the new thing that we're gonna try to cover, and we kind of hinted at this yesterday. We're gonna really focus on systems of equations today, and the two methods of actually solving that. That's kind of that's the idea that I want to get to today. The actual two methods and which one is which one you prefer. We're going to try to do two problems today because I think we set up a problem yesterday, but we never finished it. It was the last problem of the day. I want to finish that one today and then move on to our new problem because we have a new one. Now, the big thing is, one of the main purposes today is to know when you should use the system versus when you shouldn't. I think that's the biggest thing that we need to figure out. The reason being is that sometimes your problems are a lot easier than you think they are. You just have to know how to look at the problem and actually solve it. A lot of the homework that we're gonna see today, which is it's a really small assignment, looks kinda like what we were doing the other day where you were finding, X's and Y's. I mean, so they don't really venture off of that. Because if you look at our properties that we're going to go through today, namely theorems 6-9, 6-10, 6-11, 6-12, these were all basically the same properties we've done before. The only new one was 6-12. This had completely different wording. So as we go through this day, I'll kind of remind you what we've done for homework and what you can expect, and then what's the new stuff for today. But again, so we're going to go through this, quick review. When we hit 6-12, I do want to review that idea of a trapezoid because that is a completely different shape than what we've been working with. We will eventually get to the properties on these. That'll be, I think, section 6-6, something like that. So around 6-5 or 6-6. We'll get to those properties. But remember, yesterday,
Cheese
on
peaks.
Let's see. There we go. Yesterday we did have homework due. The reason I'm bringing this up, and I know this seems weird. The reason why I'm bringing this up, there was a lot of people that did not turn that in yesterday. That was due yesterday. It's in the grade book, and midterms are like today. So if you don't get that turned in, it stays a zero. So make sure you are working on that. Grades for you guys are completely up to date. I made sure that last night. I put in like late work, you turned it in. If you took a retake, I put it in. All that good stuff. I made sure of it. I even checked three times today to make sure that yours, Trinity, and Drew, we got a good.
I do better.
Yeah, definitely. Yes. Okay, but that one's due. So if you did not turn that in, some point today, work on it, turn it in. Maybe come in after school, ask questions, get it turned in. If you notice you were missing something for 3 weeks, get it in. I can't grade it. It's been out for 3 weeks. Like, that shouldn't be a shocker. It's been in that grade book for 3 weeks. This one was the new one. I didn't enter that last night. I had to enter that at 4 in the morning last night, just to make sure they were in.
Oh, why?
Make sure that all my grades were up today.
Did you have a lot of coffee today?
A lot.
So you were up until 4, or are you
Jeez.
Like, I put your guys' grade in at 4. I woke up at 2 and went until this morning.
That's depressing.
I did do better.
I'm sorry.
Oh, no.
I've been running.
I've been out for a long time. Oh, you can't complain that you have late nights. Why? I pulled all nighters.
No.
You pulled an
all nighter. No.
Almost.
So
what about 2? The grades until I
graduate school. That's so sad.
Did you want to make a break?
It's hard when you're the only parent in the household tonight because my wife's coming out to see us.
All right. Is she gonna be gone tonight too?
She hopefully will be back tonight. I've been watching Christian, so I have to grade at night because that's the most. All right, 6.9. This is one of the properties you already talked about. Opposite moles are equal.
This is Joel Hanson. Please come to the office. Okay. Dave Smith and Joel Hanson.
Opposite moles are equal. The shape has to be parallelogram. Now, what we've done previously on this problem, like how we've done one of these, is usually they gave us some type of problem like this, and they asked me to solve for x. Well, that was easy. In fact, some of your homework today is exactly that. You know the opposite walls are equal. It's a parallelogram. You can set those two walls equal to each other, and then solve for x. Yeah, exactly. Subtract the x across. Subtract the x across. These cancel out. So 5. That's 1x, which is x. So that's the stuff we've been doing. We've done it for 2 assignments now. You should be good at that. You should not get those wrong. The ones I'm worried about is when we get to systems. I think there's only 2 or 3 systems in your homework. But you need to know the difference between this problem and the ones we're going to work on today. That's the big key thing. All right, so let me get rid of that. That was theorem 6-9. You kind of know that the opposite walls are equal. Next. On this one, this is 6-10. The opposite angles are equal. So, a problem that we've done previously where it's been something like this, where maybe they give me 3x and they give me 2x plus 70. Something like that. Well, same idea, you set them equal to each other. Subtract the 2x across, I'm left with x equals 70, and then I can plug that in and I can figure out what all my angles are. Right? So it could be very, very straightforward. Now that number doesn't make sense, don't go with that. But that's the idea. Alright, so questions, comments about what you're going to do in your homework?
No.
That's
no.
Easy stuff you do every day.
Yeah.
Now, let's talk about the systems and stuff. How the systems are going to apply are they're going to throw different things in. So, for instance, they could throw something like this. Now, this is a system. And the idea, the hard part, let me give you a number on this. The hard part about doing a system is recognizing when you have a system and when you don't. When I set these two angles equal to each other, there's 2 variables in that equation. There's no way to just solve for x or solve for y. There's 2 variables. It has x's and y's, and they don't cancel out. So this is the part where you have to have one equation, and then you have to go after another one. So maybe there's another one on this page that you'll have to go after, and you have to stack them or do some method. So that's how I want you to know when you need to recognize it today. Like when you should do a system or not. Now, obviously, today we need to practice it. We haven't seen systems in here since last semester. We haven't had any in the homework. So I want to make sure that we actually practice it. That was the thing we were doing right at the end of class yesterday. So we're going to get to that. But does everyone understand 6-10?
Yeah.
Okay. Let's see. 6-11. The diagonals are equal. So, if you have a picture where they have certain parts on the diagonals, you can see these equal to each other. You can set these 2 equal to each other because the certain ones are equal. And that was 6-11. We've done that one quite a few. In fact, a lot of our homework problems have had that. 6-12, this is the new one. This is the one I want you to take a look at. Okay, this is the one we did yesterday. We did a proof of it. The trick was this problem, this theorem, is perfect for a test like the vocab. Because you really have to know the difference between this one and the isosceles trapezoid, which I'm going to show you in the next slide. And that was the thing I warned you of yesterday. On this one, this is a parallelogram because the same walls are equal and parallel. They're both equal and parallel at the same time. That's what makes it a parallelogram. Because what we did yesterday, I showed how we could prove that, when I draw a diagonal, the two triangles are equal and it forces the walls to be the same and the walls are parallel, that kind of thing. Well, look at the wording there. One pair of sides of a quad is both parallel and congruent at the same time, then that shape is a parallelogram. The difference here between an isosceles trapezoid is this. When you look at the definition of isosceles trapezoid, a completely different picture. It says similar wording. The key word here for isosceles trapezoid, they use other pair. One pair of sides are equal, the other pair is parallel. Not both. They're not both at the same time. So when you look at the picture, you can see that. One pair is equal, one pair is parallel. Very different than the last picture. Now, the reason why this is not a parallelogram, because of the same definition. The top and bottom, are these equal? You look at that picture, the top and bottom wall, this is the same size.
No, Mr. Ward.
Okay.
Bless you.
Bless you. All right, now, today, we need to talk about systems. We did this problem yesterday in class, this one right here. This is one of the first problems we solved it all the way. In fact, I think I did it 2 different ways. We talked about elimination, we talked about substitution, and we talked about how to solve for the two variables.
You were gone yesterday, remember?
I came back into myself this morning.
No, you didn't.
No, you didn't have the variable.
Why don't you ever show us the proof?
Yeah, you said that we'll get into the systems of you, equations.
We never got to this slide?
Nope.
No.
We never do this. All right. Okay, hey, you need your notes, write this problem down, draw it, put those things on the picture. Now I know it's blurry, sorry, I pulled the picture of the other paper in your book. It got a little blurry. Lighting was a little bit off when I took that picture. That's right, because you guys, that's right, I had a lead during your class. You guys got one less slide than everyone else, so you guys didn't see the slide. All right, this is called a system of equations. Okay, how a system works. They have two variables in them. So when I look at this picture, and I'm using like the theorems and I'm using the properties, like when I looked at this, it's very clear that I'm using theorem 611, that the certain diagonals are equal to each other. So when I set these two equal, right, those are the same diagonal, x equals the y plus 2, right? So I set that up. That problem, x equals y plus 2, that has two variables in it. I can't solve that right now. That hasn't... Just seeing this by itself, there's an infinite number of solutions. This depends on what my y is, what my x is. But the minute you have a second pair, which I do, on this picture I do have a second pairing, I have this one and this one. Now, when I set up that second equation, which is y plus 10 equals, what is that one? 2x minus 8. Now, I have two different equations, and this is the process for how you solve systems. You have to have two of them, so that I can use them together to actually solve the problem out. And we talked about this last semester, and I want to make sure that you get to see this, because it's not every problem today. The homework that I sent, I think there's only two or three of them in there. I can't avoid them anymore, because from the previous homeworks, page 407, the 398, the assignment we did before that, I've been skipping the system problems, because I want to wait for the day when most of the problems are going to start turning into these systems. And that's going to be the next couple sections. You'll see more and more of them. So I want to make sure that we know how to solve these, because you need it for algebra 2 as well. All right, now, I'm going to walk through both methods today for how to solve. My goal today is to do two of these. That's it. Do two of them so that you know it. Okay, once we're done with two, then you'll have the rest of the time where you can work. So you'll have about 10 minutes or so to kind of work on your homework today. The homework will be due next Tuesday that I'm going to give you. So I'll give you a little bit of time Monday. I'll kind of review stuff, make sure that you know how to use systems Monday. And then we'll go on to section 6.4. So you get about 10, 15 minutes maybe Monday. Okay, so here we go. It's a system, because when I rearrange these, nothing cancels out. I'll still have two variables. What I mean by two variables, I'll have x's and y's in each equation. Nothing goes away, right? All right, so for solving, there is two methods. I don't really care which method you prefer. They give you the same result. My goal right now is to show you both methods, and you can kind of pick the one that you like. So that's what we're gonna work on. Okay, so does everyone understand how I got these set up? Using the basic properties. All right, now I'm gonna click a couple of slides back, just so I can get rid of all this stuff, just so we can look at one process versus the other. Okay, so let me go up to this top one. We're gonna just talk about the elimination method. So we're going to talk about just elimination method by itself. How this works for your problem, if I get rid of all this stuff, all this clutter. How we do just elimination method by itself. You need to get both of these equations to look like this. This is the form that I want to get to. So I need to rearrange the equations until they're to this. This form that you're looking at is called standard form. The A, B, and C are just numbers. So I want to get the X and Y on the same side. And this number over here, I want it by itself, the lone number that doesn't have a variable on it. So the A, B, and C will be numbers. So like on these equations down here, let's take a look at this blue one here first. What do I need to move around on this problem to make it look like this?
You have to subtract the y.
Exactly. That's the only thing I have to do. I just have to move the y to the other side. So the x's and y's are on the same side, and then that number is by itself. So like Cookie just said, I'm going to subtract the y over to the other side. Does that make sense what it's looking like? Question?
Does it matter which order they go in? I just
go alphabetical. X, Y. If you have A's and B's, just go A first, B second.
Okay.
All right, so now the numbers in front of my X's and Y's, they're both ones. You can always put ones in front of variables. It's not zeros, they are ones. OK, Okay, so that's the first one I just rearranged by moving the wire. Remember, when I drag it across, I have to use the house, so I have to subtract it. Now, on this problem down here, I have to do a lot of things. I have to move this, I have to move quite a bit of stuff around to make it look like that. So, like, one of the things I'll do, I'll move the 2x over, I'll move the 10 over. That way I get the numbers on one side, the x and y on the other. Now, when the 2x comes over, I heard it, we subtract it, so it'll become a negative 2x. I'll move the 2x out front. The y is going to stick around, it didn't move, so it's just a 1y, it's positive. So I just move the 2x over with the y. And then when this 10 comes over, what happens with the 10?
Subtracts.
Negative 8 minus 10 more is negative 18. Okay, does everyone understand how I got to that order?
Yep.
Okay, so now that we have here, I stack the two equations on top of each other, and then we're going to go through the process of doing the system, how to eliminate. So again, I want these in your notes, because I know somebody's going to ask like they don't know how to do it, and if I see people not working on notes, I'm not going to even answer your question. Because I'm not going to waste my time teaching it because nobody does it, not listen.
Why do you change colors?
And it stays out.
I like it. It helps me focus.
There you go. All right. So now, what we do, we have to pick. So now, so these are the equations. These are what we arranged them. They're still the same thing. They just look different. I have to pick one of the letters, X or Y.
Y.
Good choice. Y.
The
reason being.
Because they're both opposites.
They're the same number, and they're opposites. That's perfect. That's what I want. I want the letter that I pick to have the same number, if possible, and I want them to be opposites. One's positive, one's negative. And that's perfect. The letter you pick, I don't even have to do anything to them. Since they're already ones, and one's positive, one's negative, all I need to do is add straight down. I don't need to do any other work. It'll actually solve itself. So when I do this, 1x plus a negative 2x.
X.
Negative 1x, or negative x, whatever you're going to call it, right? Negative 1 plus 1 is 0, so those go away. Because that's what's happening. I'm eliminating one letter. That's what's happening. 2 plus a negative 18. 16. And then the last step, I just have to solve for x, so I'll divide the 1 over. So if I divide the negative 1 over, that becomes a positive 16. That's my answer. I found x by itself. X has to be a 16 for both equations. So again, once you have the letter by itself, and they're the same numbers and they're opposites, you can add straight down, and what should happen is it should solve for one of the letters. Because one of the letters should cancel out. If you add straight down and they don't cancel out, you didn't do your math right. So you need to go back and fix that. You need to make these numbers to be the same. And I'll show you that. That'll be my second problem today, where we actually have to do a little bit of work. Because this one didn't require anything. All right, so now I found x. Now, the only thing I need to do is find the other letter. There was two variables on this problem. There was an x and a y. So what I have is I have x is 16. So I'm going to take that 16 and go back over here to one of the originals. And I'm going to plug in the 16 into one of them. It doesn't matter the equation you pick. It'll still solve out. I always just say pick one easier looking.
The one.
Yeah, this one. Right here. This is the one I want to pick. So I'm going to plug that 16 into the x over here. And that's what's going to solve it. So this is the second equation. It's the easier of the two. I'm going to take out the x and plug in the 16 into that location. Now, if there's multiple x's, you plug 16 into all the x's. Because this one could have had multiple letters. Now, over here, how do I solve for that?
You subtract the 2.
Yeah, subtract 2 across. If you subtract the cross, I get y is 14. Because I would just subtract the 2 across. And that's the idea. I found both letters. They're just going to be numbers. It can be decimals. It can be whole numbers. It doesn't matter. I just want to make sure that we know how to solve them. Now, that was the elimination method. That's the method. Some people really like that. It makes sense. You rearrange the equations and you make sure that you add straight down. Some people like that. It's too difficult. It's too many steps. They don't know like how to make these numbers the same. They don't know when they should add straight down or if they should change signs. That's when we have that second method. The second method doesn't require that you need to do any of this. You could do it a completely different way, but still find the same 16 and 14. Okay, so I'm going to show you that method. But does everyone have this one written down?
Yes.
Anyone still need it? Okay, so let me show you the second method. It's going to be the same problem. I'm not even going to change it. It's going to be the same work. But I'm going to do it a different way and still get 16 and 14 for x and y. respectively. Okay, so let me get rid of the work here. So now we're gonna go after what we call substitution method. Okay, so we're gonna do substitution. Now, how substitution works is we obviously have two equations. One of the equations usually is solved for a letter. Like one of the letters is by itself. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna use this fact that x is equal to something. X is actually equal to all of this. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go to the other equation, this equation over here, and I'm gonna take out all the x's, the thing that's by itself, and I'm gonna replace them with that thing, the thing that's in the bubble. So is there a bunch of x's over here?
One.
That's one of them, right? So that is a y plus 10, 2x minus 8. All right, so there is an x on that problem. There's actually two of them, like I heard. But I'm gonna take out the x in that problem. So I'm taking out and putting a little bubble there. It's a parenthesis. And I'm going to plug in what x is actually equal to. X is represented by y plus 2. I'm going to plug that in. So I'm going to take out that problem. I'm going to plug a y plus 2 into the spot. The reason being, all x's can be replaced with y plus 2. That's why I did that over here. Now, all I need to do is solve that problem out. If I solve that, it'll tell me what y is, because that problem now only has one variable on it. That's an algebra 1 problem that you did back in algebra 1, right? So, how do I deal with the 2 here?
Just distribute it,
right? You multiply it on, so it's y plus 10 equals 2y plus 4, because I multiply both numbers by 2s, and I have that minus 8 out back. I'll move the y's around, I'll move the numbers around, so I'll need to move this 2y across, I'll need to move the 10 over, to get the y's by itself, so 1y minus 2y. Moving the 10 across, I have 4 minus 8 minus 10. So I'll move the 10 over and subtract it. And so on the left side, I'm left with a negative 1y, because 1 minus 2. Over here, 4 minus 8 is negative 4, minus 10 more is negative 14. And what's the last step?
Divide by negative 1.
So my y turns out to be a 14, like we said earlier. Doesn't matter if you did the elimination method or you did substitution, you'll get the same numbers no matter what. Some people like that. That makes way more sense. That's just doing algebra 1 skills. As opposed to the elimination method, which is more like algebra 2. Question.
Like, what if the... For, like, plugging it in, you know?
Yeah.
Like, what if it's, like, 2x equals 3y plus 2? Like, what if they, like, get separately? Like,
oh.
X?
So if these equations aren't like solved where the x is by itself, you have to get it by itself before you can start plugging things in.
Okay.
Yeah, so I when I'm thinking about doing these problems myself, I would only do substitution if the start of the problem looked like this.
Okay.
That's when I would choose to do it. I actually always prefer the other method.
Okay.
I think the other method is actually faster. This took a lot more steps. Because I still have to keep going, right? I still haven't even plugged in y yet. So I have to take that y and go back over here and still plug it in and actually find the x number. Because when I take that 14 and I plug it in over here for y, I still have to find x, which is 16. They're the same numbers. It just, we went into kind of different order. Okay, questions? All right, now, what we're going to do, I'm going to do one more. We only got one more of these to do. We're going to just pick one of the methods. So if you like the elimination, or you want to see that one more time because it is faster, or if you want to see substitution because maybe that's your cup of tea, we'll pick that on the next problem. Next problem, I'll give you a different picture. It'll have different variables, but it'll still be a system because we haven't seen these for a while. So I want to make sure we get some more practice with this. Okay, but is there any questions on this one now? Anyone still need that work that I just did? Okay, perfect. Let's go to that second problem now, the last problem today. And I picked this problem on purpose. The reason being is that when I saw it in the book, and by the way, these are out of the book. This problem in particular, this one. The reason why I picked this problem is it looks like it has three letters in it. That, by the way, this is not a 2. That is a third letter.
That is a Z.
And it's a Z. And when most people look at it, they go, there's three letters. You can't do three letters. They're actually tricking you. Because the Y and the Z, since they're across from each other, These are actually the same, so you could actually just replace this with a y. So it's actually only a two-letter problem. So, because remember, opposite angles are equal. So I can just replace the z with a y.
So they're just trying to mess with you to see if you're actually paying attention. But
it is a two-variable problem. Now, the trick is, we do have to set up the equations. We have to figure out two separate equations on how to do this problem. This problem can actually be set up four or five different ways, depending on how you want to do it. But let's start with one to show you that it is a system in the first place. So, for instance, I'm not going to set y equal y. That would just be silly. These two. Let's go with these two. These are the obvious ones. Those should be equal. So I can set that up. So 2x plus 3 should be equal to the y plus x. So do you agree that it has two variables?
Yes.
Okay. It has two. I know that there's more than two letters, but it has two different letters, x and y. Okay, so that's one. I do need a secondary equation, though. That's one equation. I do need a second one. And this is the problem. When most people look at this problem, they kind of go, I only got one. Because if I try to go the other way, that doesn't work. You got to think outside the box a little bit.
It would be 2y.
Can you do 2x plus 3 equals y equals?
Yeah. That's a great way to think. I could go this direction, and that would be my secondary problem. That you can go any direction because you can use any of the properties we've learned. So the 2x plus 3 plus y should equal 180 because these angles are side by side, so they have to add up to be 180. So that's a secondary equation, and it has two variables. You got to think outside the box. I could have went a different route. Maybe you didn't see that one. That was good, by the way. Maybe you went this route. Same idea. You added these two and made 180. Same thing. We'll it's a different looking problem, but you can still solve it. Still have the same answer.
Yeah, how do you do that?
You go y plus x equals 180.
Oh, you went do 2y plus x?
Yeah, you can do that. We'll simplify it, but yeah, it'd be 2y plus x equals 180.
Okay.
I even had somebody in the first period today actually says, what do all four of these have to add up to be?
360.
That's another completely different equation. Yeah. That plus that plus that plus that equals 360.
Oh, geez.
Yeah. So you'd have a bunch of different ones.
Jesus is a friend of mine.
So there's a lot of different ways we could approach this problem. Okay,
oh,
but
Jesus.
I already have two set up. Now, is there one method that you'd like to try more than the other? I can tell you right now, I would not want to do this by substitution right now. Because none of these equations are solved for life.
Elimination
is a good choice. Alright, so I know that seems like I'm trying to force your hand, but I would not want to do substitution because when I look at these, they're not solved for a single letter by itself. So you could do it, I just don't prefer it. Okay, so let's do elimination method. So we need to rearrange these. So I need to get them so that they look like this. I'll give you maybe 1 minute. All I want you to do is rearrange these equations so they look like this form. Let's see if you can do that. That's something you should have done in algebra 1 before. I'll give you 1 minute. Let's see if you can figure that out.
No, you
want to
set them up in standard form.
I'm going to give them the standard form.
What's that mean?
So, on this blue equation, what do I need to move around to make it look like this? What do I need to move?
Minus 3.
Yeah,
sorry.
Move the 3 over. So, when I move the 3 over, it becomes 2x plus y equals 176.
177.
All right, so 177. All right, now, the second equation, what do I need to move?
Subtract the x over.
Okay.
And then subtract.
Bring these over. Bring the 3 over. So, I think it would have been easier just bring the 2x, just hang. But, all right. So, move those over, bring the 3 over. So, when I do that, I'm going to subtract the 1x, subtract the 1y, and I'm going to subtract the 3. So, when I do that, I'll have negative 1x, actually, positive 1x. Positive 1.
Oh.
Because it's 2 minus 1, so that's 1x. I have the negative 1y behind it. And when I move the 3 over, that's just a negative 3.
Now you can solve for 1.
Yeah, so now I can do my work where I can actually move things around. I can pick one of the letters. Maybe I'll pick x's in this case, just so we can do some more work. You should have picked y's, they had the same numbers. But I'm going to pick x's, doesn't really matter.
I need to get these to be the same number, so I'm going to multiply the bottom row by 2.
We have to be a negative 2.
And yeah, I'll need to make it negative. We'll do that here in a minute.
Okay.
So top row, I'm going to leave that alone. A 30 has a 2 sitting there. I'm going to multiply the bottom row by 2. So that's 2 minus 2y equals negative 6. I multiply the whole row by 2. So that way the x's have the same number. I need to make one of the rows negative. Let's do the bottom row. So I need to make the whole row negative because I need to make sure there's a negative 2 in the front. So it's a negative 2, positive 2, positive 6 now. And then, so now that they're opposites and they're the same number, now I can add straight down. So 2 minus 2?
0.
0. 1 plus 2?
3.
3. And add straight down?
183.
And the last step, divide by 3. So if I divide by 3 across, y turns out to be a 6, 1.
I can divide.
So 61. Now what I would do with that 61 is plug it back in. And I would pick one of these, plug it in, and that's a Y number, so maybe I'll plug it in here. So 2X plus 3 plus 61 equals 180, because I plugged the 61 in here. This adds up to be 64, and I would subtract that across. I would subtract this subtract the 64 across, and that's a 116. And divide by 2, and I get 58. Okay. All right. That's how you do elimination method. If you did that, if you actually picked the y's, you didn't have to do anything. You could have just added straight down. So if you did 174 divided by 3, did you say 4 or 3? Oh yeah, that works out. 58. I think it's 52 divided by 4. Okay. All right.
Yeah.
Homework today. Here's your homework. Hey, on Monday, I'll probably give your guys' class more time to work than others because you guys didn't have as much time today to work. But other classes might only get 5 to 10 minutes. You guys might actually get 20. So.
Oh my god.
Alright, here's your homework.
No.
Okay, hey, homework's due Tuesday. Tuesday the 25th. It's page 417, 45, 18 through 20, 21 through 23. And then the last one is page 421. Now, 421 is actually the same assignment. I'm not actually jumping to a different page. It just, if I just said 45, 18 through 20, 21 through 25, 15, 2 through 54, you had to flip back like a couple pages to find these. So I just saved the trouble and just told you what page you're on. Okay. These are actually review problems that have already previously done. What these are, if you want to know, these problems are like finding interior angles or exterior angles on a picture. So, what would all the angles have to be on the screen?
Why did you say 18 to 20?
I broke that by section. Because when I pick up, I actually pick like the section. Yeah. I do it all the time.
Sometimes you get high on it.
Yeah. Usually I don't. Usually, because when I'm going through the book and I'm trying to pick problems that we talked about, I grab sections. I don't actually think about where those numbers are. Okay, alright, there you go. It's due Tuesday now. Remember, today, check your grade. If you're missing a page 407 or something, get it in by the end of the day so I can get it graded. So that's been out for a couple weeks. There's no excuse for not having those for a month.
What the heck?
That's
a lot more.
I alright, there you go. I'll leave that in the board.
Just a sprinkle of water.
A tree?
It's a part of the tree.
I can
think of
it's gonna be
Exactly. You put it like
I wanted to go, but I don't track me.
You suck.
I'm not going to be able to do it.
Wait, what?
Fun. Like for people in the